Always a favourite on every rural road. Hyundai Country Calendar.
They're a family of risk takers who think outside the square.
I'm too scared to take them away just in case that's what's working.
They brought hydroponics to Northland and grow some of the best berries around. And they want a future for themselves and their staff, no matter what their background.
For us, I think everyone deserves a second chance.
It's the start of the harvest season at the Mallee's Berry Farm at Maungatapiri on the outskirts of Whangarei. Before staff can get through the gate to start work, there's an important job to be done.
It's all right.
The entrance to the property is surrounded by a well-established kiwifruit orchard. Patrick Mallee says the organic spray is the first line of defence against PSA entering the property.
It's also there to prevent the spread of any diseases we don't know about. And I guess more importantly, to signal for visitors and particularly staff that you're here at work now, biosecurity is important, we can't afford to spread disease, plug your brain on and make sure you're keeping an eye on what you're doing. And we want our staff to be mindful of that whenever they're at work.
Patrick oversees the kiwifruit production, but with the berry season underway, it's all hands on deck.
Everything's really just starting to ramp up on berries, starting to quieten off a little bit in kiwifruit, and at the heart of it, that's really what diversified horticulture is all about. It's trying to time those things together. It never works out perfectly, but hey, when you get close, it feels really good.
Just another reminder, the fruit skin is soft, so trim your fingernails if you need to. Wear gloves if you need to, whatever, just make sure we don't damage any of that fruit. Otherwise, have a great day. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Pickers are on the job early to harvest the first of the season's blackberries and raspberries. Everything's grown hydroponically.
The plants are grown in bags or pots and fed really regularly through a fertigation system. For us, that comes through these drip lines here, four per bag, and it's fed a mix of water and nutrient to really precise levels to give the plants all the energy they need to grow.
This foray into growing berries hydroponically came after Patrick and his wife Rebecca saw the fruit grown in California. They came home with a vision and wasted no time convincing Patrick's parents, Lindsay and Dermot, that this was the way of the future.
I thought that sounded very interesting and that it's a new adventure that we could try. The only problem with Dermot and Patrick is they'll get an idea and they'll both go, let's do it. And Beck and I'll sit back now, hey, go, we just need to discuss this before we do go any further.
No. Let's just do it. End of 2015, we put our first tunnels in. We started cropping in 2016. It's been a journey since then, to be honest. We thought laughing about it now would be 2 hours picking in the morning on berries and then we'll go and pick some kiwifruit in the afternoon. And it's taken over our lives, really. We're harvesting for 9 months of the year and I wouldn't go back at all.
If we leave that again for another day, it should be ready. So we just carry on.
Cool. Harvesting berries is delicate work.
You're going to pull the plug out, which is the receptacle, out from the raspberry.
Okay.
So I place the cushion part of my fingers onto it just for support.
Right.
Like so, and it comes off.
Okay.
So because I picked it like that, there's no damage around it, because like in the pack house, when it cools down, if you picked it incorrectly, you can actually see fingerprints actually on there.
Right.
Then you place it into your jug, and then you carry on.
Okay.
Growing hydroponically takes the guesswork out of producing healthy fruit. It gives the grower more control.
When you're talking about outdoor or traditional growing, you still have a level of control. You can turn the irrigation off when you want, but then it can rain and it'll absolutely saturate the soil and all that control has completely disappeared. And one of the great things coming in here with hydroponics is that, you know, we can prevent rainfall from coming on the plants and from
stuffing up the control that we actually want to have, that precise horticulture that gives us the ability to tell the plants to do what we want when we need it, with that, you know, pure focus of having the absolute best product possible.
Awesome, got there in the end.
Patrick's dad, Dermot, immigrated to New Zealand more than 40 years ago. He's been a farmer and a financier, and then grew apples in Hawke's Bay before heading north.
We like doing new things. It increases the excitement of what we do. And we do trials each year, but we try and do new things each year to learn. You can get stale if you don't keep challenging yourself and finding some new horizon to aim for. It can just get old.
Dermot's often one of the first in the orchard each morning. He and Patrick designed these scanning stations that can be moved around the property. They track the fruit from the picker to the packhouse.
There are two major changes that are happening in our farming environment. One is about the need for greater sustainability, and the other is a need for greater certainty of the food that you eat. And so traceability and provenance is fulfilling that role.
We originally started a system back in 2014 for kiwifruit, and it's blossomed more into be about how do we manage what gets picked, when it gets picked, how it gets picked, and really importantly, who picked it. Not just for the food safety, but also to really value the outcomes that people are doing. If people are picking well, we want to be able to recognise that, we want to be able to reward that, and we want to use good data to do it.
Patrick and I had a quick walk through the crop this morning. There appears to be more crop coming at the same time than perhaps last year, it's just later.
Family connection is strong for the Malleys. Every week, Patrick, Rebecca, Dermot and Lindsay hold official board meetings.
All of the market floors, Mum, are crying out for fruit at the moment. We get emails every day, and the only thing we can do with the volume we have is just cheer it around.
Depending on the mood of the boardroom, they meet either at Patrick and Rebecca's or, like today, over coffee at Dermot and Lindsay's.
We actually like the fact that either here at a dinner table or out in the field with staff, we can have robust discussions, because there's never actually only one answer. And if you're too scared to say that you disagree with something and why, you do end up sometimes going in completely the wrong direction.
So every now and again we do bang heads, for sure. But if we sit down and talk it through and come to a consensus, well, actually it's a majority vote.
You just need to all be realistic and go, it's not personal, it's business, and we're all going for the right outcome. We all want to head in the same direction. It's just about making sure it's the right path. And I love that opportunity to do that with the family.
It's a late spring morning at the Malley family's berry fruit farm below Mungatapiri near Whangarei. Lindsay Malley has already started her day.
Well, today is my day for doing the scouting in the berries. It'll take us all day at least to do that, and we walk all the tunnels. I walk a different row every week just to make sure I mix it up and don't miss things. And I'm looking for pests and diseases. And what I do like to find are good bugs, because what I am trying to do is to use good bugs to fight bad bugs. It's looking all lovely. Look at those buds up there. They're going to be raspberries very, very soon. Can't wait.
Lindsay is the company's director of plant health, and she controls the spraying program on the orchard. Every year they find new ways to reduce the level of chemicals going onto the fruit.
So I'm looking behind the leaves, because that's where we normally find predators and the bad bugs like mites and thrips, because they like to hide away from the light a bit. And caterpillars I might find right in the growing tips up here. So you need to open the leaf bud up like this and have a really good look inside, like that. I can't see any today, but it's great. My background is in medical technology and I've always enjoyed microscopic things. So give me an eyeglass or a microscope and I'm happy all day.
And Lindsay's come up with a novel way to scare off one particular pest.
When we first started growing berries here, I didn't quite know what to expect. And I went out one day and found two cabbage white caterpillars out in the raspberries, and I thought, well, that doesn't make sense because they're not brassicas. But I really didn't want them getting any ideas that raspberries were delicious, and I didn't know what to do. I don't want to spray for them. And I was doing some reading and found that they are territorial. And so I thought, well, why not have a go at making some scarecrows I put out there? So I haven't seen any since. Now, I don't know whether it's a scarecrows or not, but I'm too scared to take them away just in case that's what's working. So I'll just leave things be at the moment.
The success of the orchard has meant an increase in the need for staff. And this means the Malleys have been able to help people in the local community into work.
For us in the family, we've got a pretty simple rule, really, is that your history starts and stops at the orchard gate. So the year that you've had before you've come here is nowhere near as important as the first hour, you know, the first day, the first week when you come on site here. And we've had lots of people come and work for us with checkered histories. And for us, I think everyone deserves a second chance. And there's a lot of people out there that have made mistakes, and some of those mistakes are pretty big mistakes, and they wanted to come here and sort of reset their lives.
And so we could tell you a little bit about the checkered past. I remember one time taking the team out for a fishing trip. We had 20 of them.
Yeah, about 20.
About 20 of them on board. And we went out through Whangarei Harbour, and we were getting out to just out by the refinery. And all of a sudden, a number of phones went off, and five of the guys walked up to me with their phones saying, would you like to tell the police we're not leaving the country? Because they all had bracelets, and I didn't actually know that at the time.
And under the vines, those values are bearing fruit. Robert Manuel has worked here for 4 years and loves being part of a settled workforce.
It's mean working with the brothers there. We all get along, all like family. Got two kids, two girls, a missus, they're good. It feels good waking up in the morning and being able to support your family.
Yep.
Yeah, nothing better than that.
We're looking for doubles and triples, and we're just taking out those at the moment, then leaving the king fruit, so the main fruit on the stalk, and also just our number thin, so we're just thinning down our numbers, so it's the right amount for our canes, so you know we're not wasting energy on fruit that doesn't really need it.
Turiuti Heta has been working here for 2.5 years.
So you know everyone's got to live, got to make their coin at the end of the day. So yeah, support the family, carry on I guess.
Some of the staff have joined the Malleys straight from school. Walter Tuhiwai Po is 20 and he's been with the family business here for 4 years.
I got like hydro ladder ticket, I just got like my horticulture tickets, like level 3 in that. I've done everything in kiwifruit. I actually like picking kiwifruit myself because it's pretty physical and full on, and I like getting fit and keeping fit in that. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's my favourite anyway.
We are picking hundreds of thousands of raspberries every day, or blackberries or kiwifruit when we come to that part of harvest, and you need people that are reliable and going to turn up to work.
The reason that you're prepared to make that investment is that you keep the people long enough to actually get them to repetitively deliver those skills. It's really silly to train someone and then lose them after 5 minutes. We need to retain those staff, and therefore we need to find the right environment to keep them. And that, yes, that's how you get good community involvement.
Everyone can eat. Enjoy.
In the heat of the summer pick, the Malleys do ice block runs for their staff. And when everyone's busy in the orchard, pizza nights are popular.
Now, when people are working hard, sure, you'll pay them for the work that they're here, but you also do want to genuinely say thank you and get the chance when they're all sitting down to have a chat to them and say that face-to-face. And, you know, things like the pizza night are a great night for us to be able to say that to a whole group of people and also, I guess, identify those people that are really trying hard and make sure that they've been thanked in front of their peers.
Thank you.
Harvest time is hectic at the Mellies Berry Fruit Orchard at Mongatapiri in Northland. The days are long, but everyone knows they're an important part of the team effort to get the fruit to market.
You always have good colour, David.
At the packhouse, staff are racing time and temperature, working quickly to ensure the delicate fruit remains in top condition.
Every hour outside of the cool chain, you lose a day of shelf life. So it's critical that we get the fruit down to temperature as quickly as possible, the whole way through till it gets to the consumer, because every single minute that you have it in the cool chain, it's got more life when it gets to the consumer. It's got more chance of you know, making it through the couple of days in the fridge before everyone gobbles it up and buys another pint.
Juicy fruit. Keep an eye on it.
As a grower, you want every single fruit to go in a punnet, but as a packer, you actually want only the best fruit to go in a punnet. So, you know, one of the biggest rules of thumb that we've got in the packhouse is, if you wouldn't buy it in a supermarket, why would it go in a punnet?
All this hydroponically grown fruit wouldn't be possible without a reliable water source. The Mallees use water from this lake on their property and a new reservoir to feed their crops.
We're a big user of the local water scheme here in Mongatapiri, but we've also done a lot of work on making sure that we're much more sustainable in that water use. The whole area that we've got here under tunnels actually captures rainwater, and we either use that rainwater to funnel it into our own reservoir for later use, or we actually put it back into the aquifer underground.
The Mallees' new 4-hectare blueberry expansion is due to come into production later in the year. They're aiming to be 100% environmentally sustainable. Even these fence posts made from recycled plastic are destined to last for more than 150 years. The development has been helped along by a loan from the Provincial Growth Fund. Patrick says it's allowing them to take a few risks to expand and create employment.
We moved to Northland back in 2011, and there was 3 full-time staff members on this orchard. And we're at 37 hectares with almost 60 full-time staff now, and about 120, 140 casuals for 9 months of the year. And my ambition over the next couple of years is to flip those numbers around. So I'd like to see 130 full-time staff and, you know, a smaller amount of casuals. I really want to try and prove that sustainable local employment is possible in horticulture.
At the start of the season, when raspberries command high prices, trucks are constantly collecting fruit for delivery to Auckland and the South Island.
So these are blackberries and raspberries grown on my family's orchards.
Whereabouts?
Just west of Whangarei. Mm. Yeah, and so these were freshly picked yesterday. Mm. We pick, pack and dispatch every day to make sure we get the fresh berries to the supermarket, to the consumers. Do you want to try raspberry as well?
Yeah.
The berry fruit market is competitive, so it's important to get their brand in front of Auckland shoppers. Patrick and his marketing team often make the trip south in a bid to get customers to understand more about hydroponics and to taste the sweetness of their fruit.
Have a great time, guys. Thank you very much.
Back home, and the family's horticultural future looks to be in excellent hands.
4-1-8.
That's a very heavy one. That's the heaviest one so far.
Five-year-old Austin is helping Lindsay test the last of their trial blueberries.
Austin doesn't have much juice.
Don't know. I think you might be surprised.
I really do hope that Austin and Eloise get as much out of this orchard as I do, that they get the passion. And
it's from 0, 5, 10, 15.
Great. I'll write that down while I remember.
I'll catch you soon.
Oh, yum, eat it.
Part of that passion also means a multi-generational business that works for the family and the staff.
Yeah. Straight up. Oh, well.
We're looking at ways that they can benefit from this business other than just a wage.
He's ready for the dunks from
bro,
the
you know what we got?
That's looking at medical plans and share option schemes and all sorts of stuff. It needs to be multi-generational because it needs to set up both them and their kids to be sustainable. There's a huge amount of area of land that could grow really good horticultural crops up here that can feed, you know, thousands of New Zealanders and go for export and make Northland a whole lot of money. And so we want to be part of putting those things together for us on our home orchard, but for others as well.
Calendar was brought to you by Hyundai New Zealand.